Pogo's HCSGI and Silicon Mechanics for sponsoring the conference. Without their support, this would not have been possible, so thank you. Topic of the hour is actually one of the most talked about topic in the industry today. It is on OpenStack, and it's about Swift and everything that's related to it. Joining us this morning is Alex Eisman, who's the co-founder for Nexenta Systems. Alex does not need an introduction to the community. Prior to founding Nexenta, he led the engineering teams at Neterion and Silverback Systems, which was then acquired by Brocade. And I know he's very passionate about this topic, and I can assure you that, you know, the discussion will be interesting, it will be engaging. Without further ado, let me turn this over to Alex and take it away.
Good morning, guys, good afternoon. So this is about object storage. You see my slides, you can chat, pass messages, send me messages, and I hope you hear me okay. So, okay, just getting to, you know, the gist of it. What is it, CCOW? CCOW is the term that means cloud copy on write. I'm going to explain it in the context of, you know, Swift and the object storage and so on a little bit, and just give you more context around this. Like about a year, maybe a year and a half ago, we started seriously and really thinking about, amplifying Nexenta store appliance with object storage. We looked at various technologies, evaluated, and certainly decided to use OpenStack. We certainly did some stuff on OpenStack. Swift contributed various pages. There is one page that we still think it's very important for OpenStack acceptance, so the LFS local file system, which would allow us to put ZFS, to use ZFS natively as, or any other file system, you know, except XFS for object storage. And this is kind of the beginning. And gradually we came up with this technology called Cloud Copy on Write. The term close to our heart in the sense that ZFS itself is copy on write, and we are building this distributed object storage system that is also copy on write. That's where the kind of the context, where the term comes from. So, derivative from Swift. Now we are running Swift 1.7.5. I think it's more or less the latest, or close to the latest. And the product that we built on top of this, or using this technology, is called Nexenta Object Storage, NOST. Sometimes Nexenta Object Storage or OpenStack. One reference that is, you do not see it in this presentation, is that there is a subdomain called cloudstorage.nexenta.com, and we are going to open it for free storage usage. As of now, as of this exact time, actually runs Nexenta Object Storage and runs CCOW inside. You can kind of get a feel, you know, of how it runs and uses and is getting used. Storage.nexenta.com. It is our corporate cloud that we just opened for Unity and potential partners. So, now CCOW, as you see on the slide, it provides storage. One of the requirements which is implemented at this point is distributed versioning, distributed and distributed deduplication. We make sure that we store a limited number of versions, unlimited in the sense that limited only by capacity, not by design. And you know, deduplication that we provide is across the entire cloud storage. It may be multi-region, multi-host, certainly multi-storage server, and a given piece of an object, a chunk, lives in one replica, an instance on this probably vast cloud. So those were early requirements, and we are very happy to say that the stuff is actually implemented at this point. The last bullet on this one says something about local storage. This is an important distinction here. We also build cloud in such a way that, you know, your clients do not need to go through network to perform object storage operations. It's an important concept that becomes much more desirable, you know, especially when, you know, for any virtualized infrastructure. You do want to have a storage providing agent or server or something close to client virtual machines that run inside hypervisors. Sikao is designed to be one of those virtual storage virtual machines to provide local storage. Certainly, you know, it's a mouthful. I'm gonna, you know, shed light on it later if I have time. Cloud on right, I kind of talked about it. Two types of kind of assets, thingies, you know, in object storage. Manifest and chunks. Contain metadata, chunks contain, sort of object. Each object is divided by chunks into chunks from like one chunk to unlimited. So the motivations, and again, this is the stuff, one of the patterns we wrote behind this Sikao technology uses this concept or motivation to have metadata and data operation highly decoupled. and it kind of hints on this in the first place. But do not track chunk locations. Chunk do not track manifest locations. Very important, because this simplifies drastically your object, which is otherwise is prone to, you know, corner cases and races and conditions known in the industry for the last 10, 20 years. A little bit more in depth on how do actually we do it. Scalability, hear about it, every single time, and something is, it's certainly a very popular and very marketable checkpoint. But what I can say about Sikao is that it is designed from ground up, from day one, have no limits on scalability. And the fact that I mentioned this two existing subsystems and this very high level of decoupling ratio. But exactly what makes this scalability possible. This is very high level picture, like 10,000 feet. I'm going to talk more about it if I have time in the session later during this presentation. One of the things that, you know, people who implement object storage, distributed, any kind of distributed storage, including object storage, have to look for, problems that haunt those systems. For instance, stale copy, problem that is very much present in HFS Hadoop. You have to somehow have non-trivial logic to find out those non-referenced pieces of data and remove them. Distributed log manager, very tough thing to implement. In Sikao, we just have this was at all, right? Log manager, this distributed log management does not exist. Configuration of replication groups across the entire cloud namespace. Monitor versus servers versus slave servers versus monitoring servers. All the patterns exist in distributed object storage, distributed storage in general. In Sikao, we came a long way in a relatively short time, also because by design, this stuff does not exist. Works. This is the first, stepping down from like 10,000 feet right now, and maybe it will start giving you some kind of feel for how exactly you know it works. I made a picture that's a client. It shows so-called put-get agent. Sometimes you know we call it one put, sometimes called put-get. In our case, it's actually middleware that sits on top of Swift proxy. But other client, which Chicago native client, where you know part of this put-get agent is linked into itself. In any case, you know, real client, actual client, and user client that has object, and so object gets created at some point, and at some point later, or at some point, it's getting sent to this put-get agent. Behind itself has a chunk agent and manifest agent, and respectively, you know, chunk subsystem and manifest subsystem, left and right. So, you know, just a you know, footnote that this put-get agent, you know, exists in multiple instances. In our case, we don't have the single gate, single kind of bottleneck whatsoever. So, object is split in chunks. It is very important for us to support chunks from like one. Somehow, you know, one of the kind of claims to Swift, you know, I'm sure that community, you know, will fix it at some point, that chunking is kind of not ingrained from the day one. It's very important that you can take unlimited size object and look at, or you can optimize your chunk size to perform object for this kind of block storage and so on. And another is chunking is flexible. Size varies, you know, depending on various parameters, including object size, and a user can nail it down to size if they want to. Okay, chunk digest is computed. This is important. You will see how important it is, you know, later on as well. But suffice it to say for now that digest is a very strong checksum. SHA-256, SHA-512, and we are thinking about SHA-3 as well, which was finalized like 3-4 weeks ago. And then you communicate. You know, this agent communicates and sends notice, just digest, not yet chunk itself. Not chunk itself. This is important. This is where deduplication comes in. And the chunk agent can decide, okay, this chunk is already present or not, right? But on this digest. Remember, digest is, you know, it minimally is SHA-256, which is 10 power 77, which is very close to, you know, relatively close to number of functions in the universe. And this is, you know, extremely, extremely strong checksum. You know, the, you know, unimaginable probability to hit the same payload with the same digest, with a to different payload with the same digest. And so here it goes. Then this operation repeats. At this point, we create so-called back references. But I will talk more about back referencing later. We track this operation somehow. Now chunk IDs, then the next step, chunk IDs, added to manifest. And must send to manifest agent server. Chunk IDs are actually those digest. How I skipped here, production ID, overlooked it. Might need to say a few words, and you know, it probably will show up on other slides. But you know, there is an important concept in Chicago in general. You know, it's called transaction. Transaction, you know, put get are actually transactional operations. They have all the, you know, this usual ACID properties. Put and get are and post are atomic, consistent, is it and durable? The aspiration that you started to see here is actually full-blown, full-fledged transaction that has a unique transaction ID, which is unique across the entire cloud, across the entire cloud deployment. References are confirmed. Yeah, that's it. So that gives you a flavor of you know, how it actually operates. You know, people who know Swift will see a number of kind of differences here. Swift said that it's not a product that we have, Nixie Object Storage. It actually is a superset, contains both Swift rings and SQL rings, with quite a bit of reusable core across these two technologies. Since we are early stage right now, we are not going to make choice for user, right? My goal for now, just to let you know that to shed some light on SQL, which is, you know, a very distinct kind of that we run and the way to structure and format all data. But Swift is certainly very much existent. We are going to follow and take it on for at least foreseeable future, for at least 2013 as well. And we definitely intend to contribute everything that we have on SQL side and the pieces that overlap between SQL and Swift definitely contribute to Swift in real time. In fact, you can find our attributions as forums in OpenStack right now. Okay, so that's basically the same. You see here those kind of players. You have you see here a client. You see PutGet broker. I was talking about it was called PutGet agent on a previous slide. Has an option to bypass PutGet broker. That's what I mentioned once. Maybe makes sense to say again. This is actually middleware that can be linked into cloud itself. And so then the chunking is performed, you know, at the client itself, right? It's very important for us, again, one of the very motivations and requirements from day one on this product technology was that we definitely want to save our network. We definitely think that in the foreseeable future, you know, 5 years at least, as far as we can see, based on all analytics and reports, or our own perception, network is going to be a scarce resource. And we definitely would like to deduplicate as close to the client as possible and save network bandwidth. And so there are kind of two conceptual subsystems. When I say two subsystems, I don't necessarily mean that they are physically separate. They are running physically separate. In fact, you know, at least at this point, we think that it makes sense to deploy them on the same boxes, on the same virtual machines. As for this locality advantage, which I already named, kind of, you know, in passing. But conceptually, those are two subsystems, you know, which are driven by respectively manifest agent and chunk agent. Oh yeah, so that's you know one footnote on HSM, and you will see that you know our cloud storage is actually structured into tiers, in some sense. A local tier, the closest client, and then you will see you know a couple more tiers later that are executed not on a fast path. It's very important concept. Many details that I'm kind of running through right now, but you know it's very important that I name this concept important design slash requirement concepts again. The subsystems are extremely decoupled. Manifest calls manifest and do not know anything about chunk locations on chunk servers, and vice versa. On a little footnote to make it more exact, to sound more exact, that on chat service we actually have back references, back and the manifest, method references, those exact object versions. Object version. So what is it manifest? It's a relatively small file. Typically you would expect a small size file. Contains effectively in our case name value pairs. Easily extensible. User it's easy in our case to add metadata. I think the same holds for Swift as well. The name value pairs are reserved. Class which important concept. It's one of those keys that is reserved and is provided by Chicago right now. Allows us to, for instance, have kind of important, this important, well, the whole story around class of storage. It's probably by itself kind of a couple hours presentation here. Just a couple of examples. You want to be able to use storage media based on cloud storage, which in turn can be found in the user SLA, for instance, right? You want to be able to control number of copies, control various other attributes, compression, encryption. Stuff is important. So this is the whole umbrella term around it is called class of storage, and it is part of the metadata that is inside the version manifest. Chunk instances, probably see it on slide. This is exactly what you would expect from a reference. One important kind of optimization thing is that, can be inlined as well. As far as performance, a small object can be inlined and exist inside. But you would have chunks living separately on storage servers, on storage servers, and referencing back those manifest files. Chat can identify is also called digest, those called fingerprint. And I already mentioned that it is very strong, cryptographically secure checksum. At this point, specifically, I'm using SHA-256, SHA-512, and again, looking into SHA-3 as well, which is already published. How these chunks are getting distributed, as manifest, we are using a consistent hash, same mechanism Swift uses to distribute payload and across partitions. In our case, it is more direct. We distribute manifests based on consistent hashing and in turn distribute chunks, objects based on consistent hashing. In the core of Chicago, and it's Swift, in some sense, leaves this Dynamo ring that was published on a white paper of 2007. Identifier. Versions of objects are unique. It's very important. The system that I'm describing here is capable to generate many unique things. We generate unique transaction identifiers, which generate unique object version identifiers, generate unique chunk fingerprints or identifiers. Now we feel very good about it. Something factors just the hint here, that each Nixenta appliance has unique so-called machine signature, which we use quite some time, quite happy with it. And certainly we are using high precision time to generate really unique stamps. I'm talking here about a combination of both some specific fashion, but you know, the point is that we can generate unique things like, you know, versions, transactions and fingerprints. You know, is important. It's important, you know, it kind of simplifies design as well. It's an important concept. Distributed architecture. So here we introduce storage server. Storage server can be function, can be bare metal. Remember I mentioned NOST in the first slide. NOST is a project, is a product. We are closing on so-called intro beta. And remember cloudstorage.nixenta.com runs Nixenta storage with Chicago inside right now. Cloud storage Nixenta.com runs a number of virtual machines in reality, distributed over several ESX servers. So that's what it is. Certainly, as far as software is concerned, it is an ISO, can be etcd installed in bare metal, and that's part of your bare metal storage deployment as well. No need to use hypervisors. So server typically, and in our case, and I already mentioned this as well, this fact, it contains both manifest and chunk agents, and this allows us to implement this locality principle. I'm running 2-minute deadline. Couple more interesting slides and just more flavor, more idea of how it is. Now, take a look on this slide. This is important high-level picture of this ingrained design-in tiering in object storage. You have this local server, may run both manifest and chunk agents, right, inside. And client sits very close to it. In case of virtualized infrastructure, it probably sits in the same hypervisor. Storage transactions are actually in memory. Persistence is done once client is done with put, for instance. And client can then go ahead and do various other things that are important to client. And local server will take care of distributing this content to tiers behind itself, behind the local tier. In our case, the terminology is initially selected, designated server, and other designing the servers to have more replicas. You know, one footnote that we certainly run on top of ZFS and fully leverage ZFS, and fully leverage the fact that ZFS provides this unlimited RAID capability. We can get rid of any nesting, any level. We can do mirroring of any number of ways. Default, right now at least, servers are two-way mirrored. Right, and so when we do distribute a couple replicas, we have four copies. What do we have here? Copies. Right. This is kind of interesting high-level picture. Again, the same kind of conceptual tiering model. Local server, in our case, it is Nixenta Store 4. This is for those people who are looking into partnering with us, is that this object storage is designated for version 4, which is not really released right now, but undergoing various beta plus phases and is very close to getting GA phase. And so we're basically step on step going with this object storage on top of 4.0. And so you hear, you know, this local tier, local server, and designated servers as well. I do not have time to talk about multiple regions / sites, but certainly, worth to mention that we are supporting certainly not only local subnet, local link, but you have you can have your remote link, remote site where you know all these copies are kept, and you know you can ensure that your disaster recovery is in a sense addressed. I think you can find right, guys, I'm going to hand over.
Questions, please feel free to type them in the chat window. And at this point, since we don't have time to address them, but I would keep the recording on and we'll make sure that we will follow up with answering the questions by email. They attended the session and looking forward to seeing you at our follow-up sessions tomorrow. Thank you, Alex.
Thank you.